Hey, this is Swaggers doing Titanfall 2, the single player campaign. This is on Master, so the hardest difficulty. We are going to get all the loadouts and also all of the collectible pilot helmets. I'm playing this and, walked right on the fire, took some damage. I'm playing this and Gears on Insane at the same time. And I'd put them pretty similar. This guy will not get out of the way. What's weird in this game is when you die, you get a checkpoint and enemies can reset. So, you know, if you die in the game and then you come back, an enemy you killed might be there again. Enemies might be in slightly different. There's some set guys that appear to always be in the same place, but there's also some randoms. So it's kind of interesting, but it makes filming kind of a walkthrough hard when, you know, if you're playing on the hardest difficulty and you're going to die. What this typically seems to be is kind of a two-shot kill. Master's a two-shot kill. If you get hit once, you won't die instantly, but that second shot is going to kill you. Whoa, hello. So we got our first little cutscene. This is the guy. Also, if you didn't watch my gauntlet video doing that achievement, which is to complete the gauntlet in under 33 seconds, there is a collectible helmet there. Cooper, you're in bad shape. So don't miss that one. You can go back and mission select to get those. So this is your buddy. This is the guy you were talking to in the gauntlet mission. Stay down, Cooper. BT, let's go. I wish you could do moves like that in the actual. Oh no! Stabbed in the back. excuse me. Okay, so cutscene over. Well, the first half, now the second half, now the guys are here. And you got the bad guys, and they're a little cray cray. He just cut his ear off. Cut his ear off. He's keeping it. Weirdo. Okay, so there's Blisk. You may remember Blisk from the first game. Oi! Oi, matey. And now, cutscene number three. Oh, hello. No thank you. God, so remember the first game when they were talking about how, oh, the animals is gonna, you know, the animals are gonna matter and you're gonna be able to attack the animals and they're gonna attack you, and then that didn't really happen at all. So in the campaign here, at least, I haven't even played the multiplayer yet. I love Titanfall multiplayer, but I haven't played it yet because I'm trying to get through the campaign first. But there are animals in the campaign. Oh, that had to hurt. Assist.
BT, transfer authorization to new pilot. Link. Bravo Tango 7274. Trooper, take my Titan. Use my helmet in my jump kit. This is the real thing. Take care of him.
Okay, so your buddy boy there is now gone. And time for us to take over. New user. And typical for a game, you know, you have to earn things. You don't really have to earn things, but you're not going to... Like, they don't give us double jump right away and that kind of thing. So our first thing is we need to get two batteries for our Titan BT-7274 here. So we do have cloak, and then we do, obviously, we have auto-respawning grenades. And then, you know, you have your weapons where you actually have to manage your ammo. And winner! Power. There's some apex predators over there. And let's do some wall running. We are playing Titanfall after all. Hey, whoa, 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 whoa. No, no thank you. Double jump. And there is our first collectible pilot helmet here in BT. There are two in this first mission. Yeah, we don't need to carry a pistol around. So you do have stealth. It's going to be really going to help you out in Master. It doesn't last for very long. It's really kind of go into stealth and then peek out to see where the enemies are so that you get first shot. Because they're not 100% accurate. You know, they're not going to always hit you, but they're fairly accurate. So you do have to worry about that. So if you just touch R, you're going to do a melee. If you hold down, you'll do an execution. So there is an achievement for doing an execution while you're in stealth. And there's some drones running around you need to be careful of. So we're going to do a stealth kill here. And there's an achievement, Apex Predator. Oh, you poked your little head out. See, like I said, they're pretty decent shot. But they're not invincible. You know, a head burst will kill them. Two bursts otherwise seem to be good. With all these games with animation, you have to be careful about if you've killed them or if they've just, you know, dropped down because they're injured. So make sure you do get the kill. Get some ammo, grenades, and I got shot. So let's get into cover. I'm going to tell you, don't get too attached to any one weapon, as it seems you're going to be switching a lot. Like I said, they're a good aim. They typically won't get, you know, too quickly in a row. Helmet off, 90% means dead. Oh, that was not the button I meant to press there. I was trying to go into stealth. See, they're good aim, but you are a pilot. They're just lowly grunts. So there's one guy down below now. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go into stealth. I don't ever pick up the shotgun. I think it's a great weapon. But again, we're in master, so we don't really want to get too close to people. So DMR sniper rifle, we will switch to that. Again, the stealth is so quick. You just get a couple seconds to kind of, which makes sense because you can't just be running around the entire game. Oh, hello, someone's down there. It's like final calibration in progress. This is just to get us to calibrate us for double jump, and it takes that long. There, hey, double jump is online, buddy. They really push that shotgun. A lot of these guys have that shotgun. There are ammo crates everywhere, but again, it's almost always like it's a different weapon every time. Running against the wall. They're actually firing at some of the predators. And we're going to switch to the sniper because there's going to be a series of three Rubit snipers up on the top ledge. Headshot will do it. And then after these three, plus the drone, there's going to be a series of three more that'll drop down on you. Whoa! Let's get away. After these guys are dead, there could be some. I'm going to go over there. Sometimes there seems to be guys behind those rocks. Sometimes no. I think it depends on how long the creatures stay alive. Yep, someone else is down. See, they're fighting the creatures back there, so. If they win, if the creatures are still alive, that means they probably killed all the Rubits. If the creatures are dead, that means you're going to have some more specters to take care of. So I'll show you, they'd be right where that waterfall is. But no one's in here, you can see they're all dead. Yep, let's get up top here and do our wall run. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Ghost. Start the Ghost Runner. Yeah, no, we don't really, we'll do it, but we don't really need that. I think you know how to. Oh, good thing we got double jump right now. That was convenient. Pretty sure for the most part, running through the, oh no, there's one, there's a drone guy. Most part, running through the ship here is just gonna be No enemies, just get through, find the batteries, and get back. And we're gonna find this battery. I guess, I mean, there's the little drones, but they seem pretty worthless. Down further. Okay, battery number one. Now we just got some wall jumps to get back. Dropping down, dropping down. Whee! Where'd you go? Who cares? Those guys, you can eventually destroy them, but they're just kind of a worker. So don't worry about them. Let them go about their business. The big thing with the wall jumps is you want to make sure you're the one jumping off. If it just takes you off, you don't get two jumps. Don't be messing around with my Titan. Insufficient power. Buddy, how you doing? Oh, still a little weak in the knees. Adjusting focus. Ocular system online. Yeah, I'm pretty, aren't I?
Yeah. Who are you?
I am BT-7274, a Vanguard class Titan.
I'm so pretty and witty and bright.
You may call me BT.
BT. Got it.
My systems are rebooting. But a third battery will accelerate the process. I will remain here.
Okay, so we gotta get one more battery here. Oh, there we go. Already got a winner.
Until I am mobile, I will assist you through your helmet radio when possible.
Double jumps and wall runs. So always make sure you're jumping off. Don't let it just, don't let it push you off, because that'll count as your first jump, which is not good. Voice pattern analysis indicates they are lying.
You don't think I'm that stupid, BT?
Undetermined. I will not know.
That's okay. Just make me make some, conversation choices while I'm in the middle of a wall run. Then I'm like, that was cool, but probably wasn't the smartest move with two other guys standing right there. I'd like to get back up, please. Oh, hey, buddy. Okay, let's backtrack a little bit here so we can get another run at the wall. Oh, hey, laser. I find the laser drones to be pretty worthless. They are not very good shots.
Systems have been restored. The ambush of the 9th Militia Fleet has landed us far off course from our original destination. We are located in a hostile territory. Be careful. We cannot stay here long.
I don't even know where those guys were going. Those soldiers, because they can't, they're just grunts. They can't wall run, so they're kind of stuck out there. I guess I just drop down here. Like, steal his gun and take, like, every bullet. Where are you, bad guys? Oh, yeah, there's a guy up in the building there. Oh! Come on, I just want to talk. Whoa. See, they're horrible. I don't know why they're so bad. You know, the grunts are pretty, like, a pretty decent shots. But those drones, they're no good. Whoa. Oh, in the face. I don't see anyone. Let's move on down. Oh, hello. Hello. Hello, sneaky man number two. God, they really want to push that shotgun. The enemies almost seem to have a lot of R201s and submachine guns, but... Oh, that was bad shooting. Oh, a couple hits there. Hemlock. Sometimes you got a sniper up there, you do that laser cannon there, that'll do some damage. I think that's a one-hit kill if you get hit by that. So definitely be careful of those. There's a couple of, I think that's the only one in this level, but they start using them as security in more levels. There we go. And then I'm going to go check the building here. I don't believe anyone's left alive in here. But we can load up on some ammo if we need it. That's the first wrong. I just wanted to check that grenade out. I thought that one might have been defective. Okay, so nothing else to see here. We're going to head up to where that turret was and check out if there's any more enemies up here. Any bad guys up here? Oh, whoa, hello bad guys. They kind of just, I don't know, they seem to just be, every once in a while you'll get some guys that are just kind of standing around for whatever reason. Okay, so we got to just run through another ship interior here to get to another battery. I think this is a different half of the same ship. I think this is still the McAllister. Look up. Nope, it's not the flames. Like, oh, look, there's a gap there. Oh, look! There's tons of gaps. Walk through here, and we're gonna be at the second battery. There we go. Don't miss the jump. And then just drop down. And right through here, we will find our second of two helmets up there, glowing bright pinky purple. Boom. And all the helmets, as soon as you grab them, you're done. You pick them up. That's all you need to do. Oh, they consider that a death. And that's going to be a death too. You got to hit. It's a tougher. You got to drop down just a little bit. And then hit so that you're on. Yeah, so you're on like the bright part of it. And there you go. We are back at BT. Oh, someone's shooting at us. Rubitz! Crazy Rubitz! Yeah, apparently not hitting anything. There you are, Rubitz. Okay, install the battery. And then we're going to get into the Titan for the first time and learn about our basics if you haven't played before. Learn about the Vortex Shield and the lock-on rockets.
Pilot, we must establish a neural link.
BT Prime, fully powered.
Please embark when ready.
All right. All right, all right.
Protocol
1, link to pilot.
Neuralink established. Rifleman Jack Cooper, you are now confirmed as acting pilot of BT-7274.
I am somebody now, Daddy. I'm a pilot.
Uphold the mission. Our orders are to resume special operation 217.
So it's interesting to note that upholding the mission is more important to the Titan than protecting the pilot. Protocol 2, make sure the mission. After that, after you've got the mission done, then if you've got some time left over, you know, protect the pilot. Why is it not grabbing them and throwing them back? Ooh, we're taking some massive damage here.
Primary weapon control and motion link reestablished.
So the rockets and all that are fun, but really just using your cannon is going to do the most damage.
Great, just got to kill a few bad guys.
So we're going to fight one generic Titan. Generic Titans do not go into emergency state, so you can't, you know, go for a melee kill. Nice little spin move there, but he went boom. And there you go. That is mission one on Master. We're going to be kind of working on this and doing Gears of War Insane. Hopefully we'll get these done before Call of Duty comes out. Thanks for watching. Comment below. Subscribe if you're new. Blah, blah, blah. Have a good day.